In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today is the Sunday of reading, that we are reading the Sunday before the Lent. And the Sunday before the Lent, I will share with you a couple of I will be able to connect. Okay, it is connected. So, in the last Sunday before the Lent, there will be frequently asked questions. There will be a rule for fasting. And then we'll talk about some exercises. So the frequently asked questions, this is, it's very funny, but this is, it's like every, عارف لما كن شفت موفي قبل كده, we are seeing the movie every year, the same exact details, the same exact questions, maybe different people, but it is the same. Can I skip? Can I start late abuna? Can I eat this and that? Because my stomach, my... Is it okay to eat this? Can I start from the middle week, the middle of the Lent? My doctor told me that, you know, if you fast, don't fast very rigorous fasting because your health is... Fasting is commitment, and commitment is... Fasting is commitment, and commitment is a. Can you read? Well, it's not clear the screen. And commitment is love. And I can't bargain with you how much you should love God. I can't go with you in a deal. Okay, you want to visit a day? Are you going to love God that much? You can add this day. You can take it with. For the little kids. You ask your father of confession and your parents when it is good time to fast. Okay? But junior high and up, no excuse. Junior high and up, no excuse. Big time. And I will tell you why. Because fasting, you also one of the we will go through the time or the sayings of the fathers. But remember this, fasting is commitment, and commitment is... لا, احنا العدد كبير قوي, فانا شايفه كلكم. Fasting is commitment, and commitment is love. Don't bargain with me, طب اصل انا كان ظهري, رجلي, صداع, I'm busy, I cannot focus, I have exam, I have this operation. Fasting is a commitment, and commitment is love. And don't bargain with me about if God loves you or how much you are going to love God. Let us not go in this. Fasting exercises. What shall I do? The theme of the Lent can be many, many things. Create in me a clean heart, O God, so as I can see you in this Lent. Control your tongue, your stomach, and your heart. Disconnect to connect. The challenge in the fasting, it is not in the food, by the way. Ambassador Rabin Al-Kib'ar, and I love this saying. He said the only thing that is left out in the fasting is what? Lahma? No. The only thing that is left out in fasting is what? Yani, everything in the fast is already wasted. Except only one thing that we still have it and hold fast to it as much as we can. Abstinence. Sum al-qata'i. Because you name it, you go to, you name it, literally you name it, you need the sausages, chicken, shrimp, imitation, you can get anything imitation, and you can get any type of food So, and you will have whatever you are thinking and dreaming of. Is this is the fast that God is asking from us? Is it changing diets? Is it okay now? I'm drinking coffee with milk. Now I'm going to drink coffee with almond milk. Yeah, is this is really what is making the difference in our spiritual life and what will let us grow spiritually? Ordering your coffee with soy milk instead of regular milk or 2%. دفع قعدت مع واحد مرة ينegotiate about half and half. We took half an hour negotiating about half and half. And he told me, no, half and half, that's the army. And I was new in the country, and I didn't know what is half and half. And I told him, is it really half and half? It's the army. He told me, yes, it is half and half. It is not full. And I told him, okay, let me give me time. I will search and return back to you. فرحت. I googled what is half and half. Half, what do you know what is half and half? Half and half for what? What? Yeah, half milk and half cream and half fat. Well, half and half. It is half and half. We don't need to go in those details because this is not what God is looking for. This is not what God is asking. Otherwise, we will be more hypocritical than other religion. This is not what God is intending and looking for and requesting and seeking to see in us. So if you return back he who fasts from the food but his heart not fasting from hatred and envy and his tongue utters deceit, his fast is void. This is an Isaac, the seeding. Because fasting of the tongue is better than fasting of the mouth, and fasting of the heart is better than both. God, يا ابني أعطيني قلبك ولا تلاحظ عيناك ترخي. God is seeking the heart. God is not looking after what we eat and what we don't eat, and either this is half and half or quarter or whatever. This is not even intended in the mind of God. But we take the form and the shape and I'm fasting, but I'm watching inappropriate stuff. I'm fasting, but I'm backbiting others. I'm fasting, and I'm not honest in my prayer. I'm fasting, and I'm seeing a homeless guy and I don't want to help him. I'm fasting. Where is really the fast? Fasting of the tongue by not saying a bad word is better than fasting of the mouth, not eating. And fasting of the heart, not sinning, is better than both. And remember, fasting is commitment, and commitment is love. So let us not bargain with God how much I'm going to fast. Is this is fasting? Is this not fasting? And the left out, the only thing that is left out in fasting is the abstinence, or sumal qutai. So the first exercise in the fast, take it gradual. My recommendation, as I told you, from junior high and up, start the fast. If you haven't fasted the whole fast before, return back to your father of confession and get guidance how you can catch up in this. But think of this, if you started fasting, 8-7 weeks, if you started fasting till 12 in the first week, till noon. Tamam, if you are waking the regular timing, it's okay till noon, it's no big deal. But if you are waking 3 and 4 a.m. and waking very early in the morning, maybe fast till 11, till 10. And every week add 1 hour of extra fasting with abstinence. Yani week 1, finish your fast, break your fast. طبعاً break your fast with yummy food. By 10 a.m. Week 2, by 11. Week 3, by 12. Week 4, and grow, little by little. The first week, it is the hardest week, for me as well. I've been fasting for many years. But still, every week you are having the dizziness, and I'm fainting, and I'm tahbar, and I'm... I can't focus on what is going on, and I'm hungry, and butterflies. All of this is okay. One of the best sayings about fasting in the church I have heard from a saint named Saint Sarah. القديسة سارة قالت إيه؟ قالت I will say it in both languages. نفس لا تأخذ خبزا نفس لا تأخذ خبزا لا تطلب خمرا. A soul that is not getting its bare minimum of bread will never ask for wine. And a soul that I am depriving of little bit of food is not going to tempt me or is not going to lead me to fall in temptation. What is the first thing that all the parents can answer this question? What is the best thing if you have your kids in college and they are taking off and they are leaving? What will be the, يعني, if you are going to narrow down all the virtues and tell them hold fast for one virtue, only one virtue, what will be this virtue? It is not fasting. What will be this virtue? Hold fast to this. Don't let go of this. Purity. What else? The Bible. Any ideas? Suggestion. Praying. It is self-control. From my point of view, it is self-control. When you have a self-control, you can pray, and you can live a pure life, and you can read Bible, and you can do, you can be disciplined, and you can make a lot of righteous and enlightened decisions in life. It is self-control. But what is the best thing that will make you learn self-control all your life? Fasting. It is fasting. Because simply, when I am fasting, the things that is not sinful, I'm telling myself, oh, well, coffee is sin. El coffee is sin. No, I'm telling myself, no, that I want to share coffee already, no. So I'm telling myself that something that is not sin, no, not now. So it gives me, it rewires my brain to tell myself when it is something sinful, then it is definitely wrong. Are you getting it? So, first thing, fasting is commitment, and commitment is love. And let us not bargain how much we want to love God. Number two, the left, the only thing that is there from fasting is abstinence. And let us take it as much as we can. If you never fasted with abstinence ever in your life, start with fasting with till 9 a.m. Second week till 10 a.m. and add one week after, 1 hour every week. By the seventh week, you will be 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4. You will be fasting till 5 p.m. if you started fasting with 9 a.m. in the morning. It is little gradual growth. So, funny story with Saint Macarius. I will tell you the story and I will stop here. Saint Macarius once was praying that God will send him someone to give him a word of advice. So he was walking and he told God, please send me a word of advice. So he was walking and he found a teenager taking care of the sheep. So he told him, what do you think if you eat and you are not full? What do you do? So he told him, eat again. And he told him, if I eat again and I'm not full, he told him, eat again. He told him, if I eat for the third time and I'm not full, he told him, most probably you are a donkey. You are like an animal, you are just eating all the time and you cannot stop yourself. And Saint Macarius said, this is enough for me. He was thinking of the fasting. Because it is sometimes, okay, you know what? طب let us fast till 3 p.m. And I remember a guy in my school. It was a very funny conversation. I don't know, we'll finish school by, I don't know, maybe 3 or 4 p.m. We had labs and a very miserable schedule. Then a guy said, you know what, let us meet and eat outside. So we are in a group, maybe a group of people. So a guy came, I cannot eat except after 5 p.m. What is eating after 5 p.m.? What has this to do with? We are going out to eat. You are going to wait from 3 to 5 to allow yourself to eat. Then I realized after I went home that he is fasting with abstinence. And he's breaking his fast at 5. But he's doing well. He's doing the opposite of what the Lord said today. If you are doing your charitable deed, do it secretly. No. Open. It is not about bragging about your relationship with God. Bragging about your commitment and your love to God, it will be taken away from us. So I'm telling you that some of the tricks also in fasting, I will fast, and after I fast, خلاص at 12 noon, I will order the unlimited food, and I will go to this place, and I will eat as much as you can. This is not also the mindset of fasting. Have you seen any of the teenagers or the kids loves very, very much a game online, or a video game, or Xbox? Have you seen any of those? And the mom is going and telling her son or her daughter, the food is ready. Later on. I don't have time now. The food is ready. The food is ready. Let me finish this. Let me do this. Let me get to this. What? He has a lot of passion to what he's doing. So that's why he put the food on a side. And this is the concept of the church. Is let us get involved that much spiritually with God. So as we put the food aside, it is not what I'm going to do and what I'm going to eat and what I'm going to. So I will stop here. May God give me that in this Lent, I give everyone that we will start fasting from the beginning, not the fast of the food, not the change of the diet, but the fast that is honorable and accepted in front of God. The fast of the tongue, the fast of the mouth, the fast of the heart, the fast of the body from any type of sin. And in the same time, let us grow spiritually. And as the Bible told us today, it is three things: charitable deeds, fasting, and prayer. So increase in your prayer, increase in your giving alms, and increase in your fasting. To whom is the glory forever and ever. Amen.